Obviously, we've had what's often termed as a natural gas revolution with unconventional production, and it is remarkable. In fact, it's interesting that there's a little bit of a reflection on the side that I think we often say that, you know, the energy business is a big, slow-moving, highly inertial business for good reason. I mean, huge capital requirements, highly regulated, et cetera, and that the typical timescale for anything big to happen in the energy business is like 25 to 50 years. Well, this is kind of a counterexample in a certain sense that, you know, 10 years ago, the general wisdom was that this was not a very productive way of going about your business, trying to produce unconventional gas, and that changed real fast. I think there's a lesson in there, and that's relevant to come back to the renewables. I think in this case, this kind of rapid change in the energy sector was clearly greatly facilitated by the fact that in the end, producing this resource was in kind of the typical value chain, supply chain of big energy companies. So it's harder when you think about now bringing in, I mean, in some sense, truly alternative technologies into the mix. So in that context, I think the way I look at it, at least, is that this natural gas boom is a boon. First of all, we all know that it is partially responsible for the decrease in CO2 emissions that we have experienced over the last years, in the absence of at least overarching legislation. Secondly, what I would argue is that the way to look at it, and you know, is gas as kind of a bridge to a very low carbon future, is that it affords us a little bit more time to develop the technologies, to lower the costs of the alternative technologies, to get the market penetration of these new technologies. The key is that buying time is not very useful if you don't use the time. So that is the point then. What does using the time means? It means pushing hard on those other technologies, on the renewable technologies. This is the time to get those ready for the marketplace on a big scale. So this is the decade, I believe, the crucial decade for us to accomplish that. Second thing I'll just say, because again, this came from also the confirmation process, is that clearly we need to continue our focus on wind, pushing more offshore wind, for example, where cost reduction is critical. Certainly pushing on solar across the board, and I say I'm very bullish on solar. I think it's going to be a lot bigger than most people think, sooner than they think, in my view. But also, as came out in the confirmation process, strong interest in different regions of the country in terms of what was termed by Chairman Wyden the forgotten renewables. They're not really forgotten, but you know, I think we do need to do a little more looking at, you know, engineered geothermal systems, at small hydropower, and other options as well.